You're not imagining. You are paying more taxes. The latest report from Congress finds individuals contributed more in taxes in 2014 than in any year since the financial crisis. In fact, the share of taxes paid by American families is growing. The share of taxes from corporations is lagging historical averages.
Hey, let's talk about it, shall we? From both sides of the aisle, Daniel Mitchell from the Cato Institute is with us, as is CNBC contributor Jared Bernstein. Good to see you both. Jared, let's start with you. What do you make of this report?
Well, I actually think that this tells you that the economy is getting better. It's one of the things that you expect when the business cycle improves, a lot more people go to work. You expect that taxes in a progressive system like ours, that is a progressive tax system, will rise. And in fact, if you go back to earlier years that were peaks in the business cycle, in 2007, we had exactly the same share. 8.1% of GDP was paid in personal tax income.
But you corporations aren't making more money and therefore paying more taxes?
Well, corporations actually are lagging, as Kelly pointed out, and that has to do with a lot of tax avoidance on the corporate side, as well as a big shift to pass-throughs. That's a very important part of this story. You've got a lot more people taking their business income on the personal side. But by the way, if you go back to 2000, where the economy was, you know, really at full employment, the individual tax share was 10%. So a couple of percentage points higher than it is today.
Yeah.
So basically a reflection of economic growth.
Daniel, you know, the income tax has been down for a little over a century. Is this really the kind of system, one that's basically become fully reliant on individual income tax, that we want to see?
Well, frankly, it doesn't matter what tax you have. People ultimately are going to pay it. We could replace the income tax with a value-added tax or national sales tax. There's still going to be some cyclical elements to it. I mean, in some sense, I agree with what Jared said, and that doesn't happen that often. Our economy's growing a little bit. So, yes, the government's collecting more revenue. And in terms of corporate taxes, I would throw in a different angle, though, than Jared. Because we have the world's highest corporate tax rate, of course companies are engaging in tax avoidance. Of course they're figuring out how to declare income outside of America rather than inside America. So I think it's actually a story about the Laffer curve, and this is an area that cries out for reform.
But Dan, I mean, corporate tax rate being the highest in the land is sort of an illusion when the companies that are subject to that higher corporate tax rate are not even paying it because they are able to avoid it. And I think that's what sticks in the craw of a lot of individual taxpayers out there. They are bearing a burden when corporations aren't paying their fair share, as they perceive it, because they are able to avoid taxes the way individuals cannot.
Two things. First of all, the corporate taxes are paid by individuals, either as workers, shareholders, and consumers. So this distinction between individuals and corporations doesn't make sense economically. But on the broader point that you're making, this is exactly why I think we should do to the corporate rate what we did to individual rates in the 1980s. Bring the rates down dramatically. There won't be this huge incentive to evade and avoid the tax system. Companies will be happier to create jobs and declare income in the United States.
Listen,
that's a win-win for the economy
and even for government.
I
thought Bill made a lot of good points there. It's certainly not the case that because people are paying less in corporate taxes, they're paying more on the individual side. I mean, that's true for the pass-throughs, but it's not true for everyone. But here's the thing. I agree with a lot of what Dan said, but so does everybody else. In other words, everybody in this town of Washington walks around saying we should do exactly that. We should lower the corporate rate and broaden the base. So why haven't we done it? Because all those people who benefit from tax avoidance, they buy a lot of lobbyists, and those lobbyists work very hard and very successfully to prevent this from happening. So what we have to recognize is that why it's very easy to say, lower the rate, broaden the base, close the loophole, every loophole has a high-paid protector somewhere, and they've been quite successful in doing their job.
Just a quick one to put this, tie this all together as well, back to these markets. Dan, it looks like, especially with the market's performance and the capital gains income we could start to see through April, this government, I mean, the budget could, how close do you think we could be to running a surplus?
I'm afraid we're still a long way away from a surplus because we're over $400 billion of red ink still. So it would take a lot of capital gains revenue, which of course are very cyclical and often one time in their impact. If we want to deal with our fiscal problem, ultimately, this isn't a tax debate. We just talked about revenues being at record levels. The problem is government keeps growing faster than the private sector, and that's a recipe for becoming greased at some point.
Just to be clear, revenues are not at record levels. Revenues are where you'd expect. Certainly the case, though, that I don't think we're going to get to a surplus without more revenues if we keep our same spending levels.
All right. Boy, we could go on all day, I know. Thank you both. Appreciate your thoughts.